Hi guys, Archie Luxury Channel. And today guys, I want to talk about this is an adopted Aussie, I think he's a New Zealander, Russell Crowe. Russell Crowe is having an auction at Sotheby's, The Art of Divorce. I don't know if there's much of an art to it, as somebody who's been divorced three times, three-piece combo deal. Normally these bitches just take everything they want. But Russell Crowe, he's a command and conquer, fantastic actor. He's auctioning off a number of his pieces. He's selling, including a Mercedes S-Class. It's a 2001. Wasn't a really great year for Mercedes. It's an S500 and it's got over 100,000 kilometers on it, which I don't think it's that fantastic. But he is selling off a number of his wristwatches. So I thought it'd be a perfect time. Let's go and take a look at what watches he's selling at auction. And let's have a bit of a look behind the guy who is Russell Crowe. Let's take a look. Okay, Mr. Crowe's wristwatch collection. Let's have a look. What has Mr. Crowe? This is famous movie star. He's an A-lister. Russell Crowe's an A-lister. He's actually born in New Zealand, but he's sort of the adopted son. He's been successful, and we'll take him. We'll take him. He's a bloke's bloke. You know, he's a top. He's actually very talented. I loved him in Commanding, whatever the fuck it was called. Okay, Panerai submersible. Very good choice, Russell. I like this piece. I've actually got a submersible on order. I've got one on order. It looks like you haven't screwed the screw in properly at the top there. Just one little criticism, Russ. Next one is a Panerai GMT. I don't really get the GMT thing on the sub, on the Panerai. I don't really get it, but okay, you were bored and stuck in an airport lounge. It happens to the best of us. Ah! Breitling Super Ocean chronograph. This is a Super Ocean 1, not the Super Ocean 2. It's got the aluminum bezel. And just like the Series 2, it's got the 7750 Valjoux movement. Nice looking piece, Russ. I will give you credit for that. It is a cool looking piece. I love the shark mesh. Bitch to undo, but hey, I will give you that. I do love a bit of shark mesh myself there. Stunning piece. You chose well. The black bezel with the black dial. Perfect. And another piece he's got is a Breitling emergency watch. Well, you don't know when you could, you would need that. That's a cool, well, it's, yeah, I don't know if I'd buy one myself. And then you got a Seawolf. Fuck. Russ, come on, man. Don't know why you bought the Seawolf. That is semi-shitter, Russ. Semi-shitter indeed. It's, not really my cup of tea. You should have given that to a staff member. Then you got a Rolex Yachtmaster. This is a Yachtmaster. Would have gone for the blue dial. Don't really like the silvery dial. Cool piece. Platinum bezel. But, yeah, it's a Rolex. It's a cool piece. Jesus Christ, your reserve is high. You're expecting to get your money back. And then you got a Tiffany & Co. What the fuck? I don't know why you'd buy this, man. That is just, I don't know. When you go to Tiffany & Co., don't buy shit. Don't buy unnecessary shit. It's dangerous, Russell. Sorry, man. Just got to tell you the truth. Cartier Roadster. Okay, I get the Cartier Roadster. I hope you've still got the rubber strap included with it. It doesn't seem to make any mention of the switchable rubber strap. I hope you got the rubber strap with it. It says with a Cartier box, but did you? Okay. Then you got the Cartier American, Tank American. I love this piece, but it's a fucking Mecca Quartz, man. Come on, you can't buy Mecca Quartz. That's the sort of thing Tom Cruise would buy. Don't buy Mecca Quartz, man. It's a cool watch. It's beautiful. I love it. But it's a fucking quartz movement, man. That's not good on our luxury watches. Yeah, get rid of that fucking thing. If you can get your money back on that, Hey, that'll be a great day indeed. Then you got a Rolex Daytona, solid gold. My God. My God, this is a beautiful piece. Black dial, solid gold. Man, it doesn't get better than this. But fuck me dead, your estimate. Where the fuck did they get that estimate from? They're not that great. The steel ones are, yes, the steel ones are going through the roof, but not the solid gold ones, Russ. I mean, fuck me dead. I don't care what sort of a fucking movie star you are. Fuck me dead. Fuck me dead. Who's going to pay huge, huge money for your cast-off Daytona? Fuck me dead. 40 to 50, you could buy a brand new one. I mean, I don't see where you're getting that from. Then you got a Cartier Pasha. Yeah, that's okay. Cartier Pasha chronograph. Yeah, okay. I like the ladies one, actually. That is a really, really cool Pasha. I think that looks sexy with the diamonds. 8 to 12. Fuck, I think you paid a bit. I think they might have, you know, that's diamonds in it. Fuck, man. What's wrong with that wench you were with? Chopard ladies white gold. Yeah, that's very classic and elegant. I don't understand this necklace. What the fuck you buy this necklace for, man? That's just crazy. Chanel black ceramic. Man, what's the fucking estimate? 30 to 40 fucking thousand? Is that a misprint? Did they put the comma in the wrong spot? Fuck me dead, a Chanel black ceramic? It's only got an ETA movement, hasn't it? Fuck me dead. What the fuck were you thinking when you bought this, man? That's too much money. That's Hollywood for you. Too much fucking money. I do like this Chopard here. This Chopard here, automatic Chopard with the nice diamonds. Very, very good for red tie events. I actually like it, even though it's a terminal brand, and we all know Chopard is fucking hard to resell for men. But hey, I like the Omega Speedmaster. Man on the moon, man on the moon. I would have preferred it with the bracelet, but hey, beggars can't be choosers. Man on the moon, Russ. Man on the fucking moon. That's a good watch. I love the moon watch, Russ. I love the moon watch. Good choice there, sunshine. Very, very good choice indeed. I love it. I love it to death. Estimate, hey, I might buy one from Joma's shop instead. I like this 1940s. I'm not sure about this dial being original. Is that a clean dial or a redone dial? I just am missing some patina. Patina. Where the fuck's the patina on the dial? Now, this Asprey watch, fuck me dead. Tell me your wife gave that to you. No man could have chosen a fucking watch this fucking ugly and thought it was cool. Come on, Russ. Tell me the truth. The Cellini. Oh, fuck. The touch of the kiss of death. It's a platinum. It's platinum. Fuck me dead. Cellini, man. That's fucking... I don't know where the fuck you... It actually looks pretty cool for a Cellini. Cellini. Yeah, I got it. I don't think it's ridiculous. I think it's okay. I must say. Then the Vacheron. The Holy Trinity. The Holy... My God, this is a beautiful day-date with Power Reserve. In platinum. I could have bought one of these in gold for about fucking 16,000. I think your estimate may be a little bit on the crazy side. The model's not that valuable. I suppose it belonged to you. I mean, that's got some real kick-ass provenance. But for 40 to 50, I'd buy myself a Lange 1815 chronograph. That's what I'd fucking buy for 40 to 60. I'd buy a fucking Lange chronograph. Not this. I'm sorry, Russ. I'm just trying to tell you the truth. I'm just trying to tell you the truth. And what the fuck is this Asprey? I know Asprey is very, very upmarket. And the rain in Spain falls mainly on the plain fuckers. But fuck me dead. What were you thinking buying this sort of thing? Russ, don't fucking do that mistake again. These are not good to buy. Then you got some shitters. Giulio Mazzaluni. What the fuck is this? It's just a shitter. Shitter, Russ. It's a shitter. It's a shitter, Russ. And this Michelinson. What the fuck were you thinking, man? You should have given that to staff at Christmas time. That's what you should have done with that watch. Then a vintage Longines. Okay, Russ, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. Don't know why the fuck you got that. The Mont Blanc, man, give that to your driver. You give that to your driver. And the Armani, man, good celebrities give these sort of shit to their staff. That's what you do. You give it to your staff or your kids' school auctions. The IWC, the Portuguesa, I quite like, yeah. But man, you're asking a bit much. It's only got a fucking Valjoux 7750 fucking me machine in behind this bastard, Russ. Come on, man. Work with me, not against me, big boy. Work with me, not fucking against me, the Armani. What the fuck? This is the sort of shit they give you in those when you go to the Academy Awards. Then you got the TB booty. What the fucking garbage is this, Russ? Russ, come on, man. This is crap. What the fuck, Russ? Russ, I wish you well on the your auction there, the Art of Divorce, man. But fuck, this is just getting rid of your garbage. I don't understand it. I don't understand it. And the Merc you're trying to sell's got over 100,000 kilometers on it. Fuck me dead, Russ. Come on, man. You got to put some good shit in the auction, not just garbage. Not just garbage. It's anyhow, look, thank you so much. Yeah, anyhow, see you later, Russ.
Okay.
Oh, guys, I forgot there. I forgot to tell you guys, I stuffed up one of my video ads. You know the ad I did for Crypto Trends? Well, sorry, just a bit of depression eating. Anyhow, the ad I did for Crypto Trends, I advertised it as Crypto Trends 2018. It's just Crypto Trends, guys. I made a mistake. Cut me some slack, would you? Crypto Trends. Go and check them out, guys. Crypto Trends. Hi, guys. Archie Luxury. Archie Luxury Channel. Paul Pluto Channel. And my good friend, Tanzillin. Answering super chats. It's not about the money. I feel like I'm doing my passion. Tanzillin. Simply the best. And he's got another one for you here. How's this? It's not about the money. It's my passion. Shitling on time. Simply the best. Now, guys, I got to tell you, I struggle to survive full-time on YouTube. Please look in the description below for 10 ways you can keep me full-time on YouTube. Guys, I really need your help. Please consider getting a paid video review. I'll do a review on any watch, any question you want. Guys, you can sponsor me on Patreon. You can sponsor me for as little as $1 a month, and that just keeps me going on full time on YouTube. Guys, you could also, I do phone calls. You can talk to me for an hour on the phone, Skype or WhatsApp, for $50. Guys, I really do need your help to stay full-time. Man cannot survive on Google Ads alone. Please help me. Please help me stay full-time on YouTube. And guys, don't forget that. It's not about the money. It's my passion. Shitling on time. Simply the best. Tanzillin, thank you. That's a sponsored bit from Tanzillin. I can do that for $150 a month if you email me directly. Look below for my email address, guys.